Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Erica with Tiny Acorn. I am so happy you're here today. I have a very big announcement today. I have some very sad news, but also I have some very exciting stuff that I'm going to be sharing with you at the end of this video. Some new adventures and some new fun things that I'm going to be embarking on, and I want you guys to be a part of it. So stay tuned for that. I guess we should just hop right into it. I have decided to take a step back from my YouTube. It's a big decision, yeah. Where to begin? As you guys know, I became a mom about a year ago, and the whole first year of Monty's life has been just figuring out what I can handle and how much help I need and how to parent him while also, you know, taking care of my own mental health as well. I've just had to continue eliminating things from my life. So when he first was born, I quickly realized that I was not going to be able to clean the house anymore. Like, I cannot do that. I can't be scrubbing toilets and cleaning floors, and there's just too much going on in my life. I don't have time for that. So I got my husband to agree to hire a house cleaner. So we did that, and I swear it's like so worth the money. I will never go back. And so we did that. And then I realized like we were also going to need to get help with just childcare, because I was trying to do this YouTube thing and my Instagram and like run my own business doing that. And I realized like I didn't really have any time set aside to work. And I could work during his naps and stuff, but those are like never guaranteed. And it was always really hard to like find time for myself to get a big chunk of work done. So we ended up deciding to move to Bakersfield from San Francisco, where we were living. And we got some help with childcare, which has been wonderful. Monty's Grammy watches him twice a week, and that gives me a nice chunk of time to get some work done. And so I was just literally, I just felt like, oh my gosh, okay, now things are gonna be different. This is gonna be great. And so we moved, we finally got settled in. And I realized like, man, I needed help. Like I still needed help. We had our house cleaner. We had, you know, Monty being watched, you know, twice a week. But I still felt like I was just struggling, like barely making it. And, you know, I would have like constant, like monthly breakdowns, just feeling so overwhelmed, feeling like I have no time for myself. Yeah, it's a lot to balance and juggle when you're a stay-at-home mom who's also trying to run a business, also trying to take care of your household and be a good wife and have a social life and keep up with your own relationships and take care of yourself and have self-care and have alone time and like all of that. There's only so many hours in a day, and no matter how much your partner helps like with the load of childcare, like it's still difficult with all of that stuff going on. Yeah, Jason works from home too, and he will frequently help throughout the day, like watch Monty and help me with that. Yeah, I just felt like, wow, okay, I have this help with him. I have help 2 days a week, but it's still not enough. So I hired an intern, and she was here for the summer. She came, she was awesome. I loved her, and she like helped me finish Monty's room, which you guys saw in his room tour and everything. Yeah, and so then she had to go back to school, and so I was realizing like, oh man, like that was so great having her. Like she would help me with like filming and taking photos and stuff like that. And I just really realized how I needed somebody to help me with like my business. And so after my summer intern left, I hired another person. I hired an assistant. If you guys follow me on my Instagram, you may have seen her. She's awesome. Her name's Elizabeth. Yeah, she has been so amazing and helped me out so much. I kind of thought like, okay, maybe now that I have Elizabeth, like life will get less stressful. Things will be easier. I'll be able to get more done. But actually it's like I hired her and she's been helping me with my social media and everything, and she's been great. But also now that I have her, we've been like doing more content, which is great, but it's also a little bit more work. So I was still feeling stressed. Like even though, you know, I had someone to watch Monty 2 days a week, I have my stay-at-home husband is working here, you know, and house cleaner, and now I have an assistant, and I'm just like, man, like things are still too crazy for me, and it's so hard to keep up with like all of my brand deliverables and like the content that I have to make for brands, my YouTube, trying to do a video every week. I had even gotten like a video editor, and I was so excited about that, because if you have a good editor, you just like, that's gold, because I'm telling you, it's just so much work to edit a YouTube video. I've done it for years on iMovie, and so I wanted to hire an editor who could kind of get my style and my vibe and then like edit the way I liked it. But even having an editor, like it takes so much time, just like transfer the files, and then you get your rough draft back, and then you have to preview that, and then you have to send back all the notes on like what changes you need made, and then get the file back, and there's just so much back and forth. So like even though I had the editor, I was kind of finding that like it wasn't really saving me any time. Like it was almost like worth it just to edit it myself, because I knew exactly what I wanted. And so it was just like the editing was taking time, the filming was taking time. And so, oh man, I was like, something's gotta give. Like, what am I gonna do? Maybe I should hire a nanny to come like one more day a week. Yeah, I was like literally this close to hiring a nanny. I just ended up feeling just this kind of shift happen where I was thinking about my YouTube, and I have just like slowly lost passion for it. I think there's like a lot of factors that are influencing that. I feel like I owe everything to YouTube, like for like where I am now. Like I owe it all to YouTube, because like when I first started, I literally just uploaded thrift hauls and thrift with me's for fun, and I didn't expect it to grow or anything, and it ended up growing, and now I'm able to, you know, make an income from it, which is fantastic, and I'm so thankful and like so incredibly thankful for all of you guys that have stuck around, who've like watched my videos and subscribed to my channel. Like literally I would not be in the position I am now like if it wasn't for you guys, and I couldn't be more thankful for you. But yeah, I just feel like something's sort of shifting in me. I have felt like it's been a little bit challenging since COVID with the videos, like especially the Thrift With Me videos, which are my most popular videos. They're the videos that everyone wants to see. They get the most views. And when brands work with me, pretty much the only videos that they want to be on are the thrift videos. So there's a lot of pressure there that I should like only make Thrift With Me content. Which that's so tiring after a while. I mean, it's fun at first, but then like it just, it's hard. It's hard work and it's exhausting. Filming, being the one behind the camera, trying to get good shots in the thrift store. There's so many different variables that you have to think about. Like, it was really challenging for me because I really wanted to connect with my audience. I feel like your facial expressions, you know, it shows so much and you can communicate so much with your audience, but as soon as you have to put a mask on to go into the thrift store, like that is all taken away from you. And I just felt like it was getting harder to connect with my audience. I felt like my videos weren't as exciting anymore, like, or personable because of that. And then it was also hard to hear like me talking in the store because it's muffled by the mask. So, I mean, these are things that I'm not the only one dealing with these issues. Like, so many other people like me are dealing with these many, many inconvenient things, you know, because of COVID. And it's just the reality of the situation, you know, but it doesn't mean that it's not inconvenient or it's not annoying. So it was just been hard to feel like I could connect with my audience through the Thrift With Me videos. And then all of the editing and everything that goes into it, I just feel like I am just kind of over it. Like, that sounds terrible, but I'm just not excited to make them anymore, and it feels like a lot of work. Yeah, and I've kind of shifted, and I've started getting approached by brands for content on Instagram now, and I have more followers on Instagram now than I do subscribers on YouTube, and so I'm noticing that, like, I am getting a lot more income coming through my Instagram platform, which has been such a blessing and so wonderful, especially because it doesn't take as much time to make that content. And so, whereas my YouTube, it would take probably like 2 or 3 days to make a video. And then on top of that, there's, even if you're working with a brand, you have to send it to the brand for pre-approval to make sure that they like how you edited it and what you said. And so there's so much stuff that goes into it that there's a lot of hours that you spend doing all that stuff. So I started realizing that, like, I was able to make more income for my family going through Instagram with less amount of work. And so I just feel like there's not a whole lot that's like keeping me invested in the YouTube platform. I do like being able to record long videos, and I like to be able to like chat with you guys and talk to you guys, and like, oh my gosh, it's so fun. Thrift hauls are so fun. I love sharing with you guys like the things that I've got, but like, I think there's just like a trade-off, you know, and it just feels like I'm to the point right now where I need to let go of something, and I feel like I've tried everything to get help for myself, get more time for myself, and it just feels like this is the like missing piece, that like it's time to just take a step back from my YouTube and start pursuing other things. And once I decided to do that, you guys, I cannot even tell you the relief I felt. So much relief. Like, my stress levels too. Oh my gosh, let's just say my stress was at like 80%, like while doing my YouTube and trying to run all those things. And once I decided to let go of my YouTube, I'm telling you, my stress went down to like 15% or something, like drastic. Because I think what it is that when I have all of these deadlines and deliverables and videos I have to do, and I know I only have like 2 days a week that I can get this stuff done, that are dedicated time for myself, it's just like this stuff is just swirling up here over my head all the time, and it's just a constant stress on me, this to-do list stress. And so I feel so much better, like literally just like mental health wise, like it feels like night and day now that I've decided to take a step back from my YouTube. I'm also feeling so just excited and passionate about a new venture that I'm going to be shifting my energies to, and that is going to be designing my own clothes. I'm so excited about it, you guys. Yeah, it's gonna be fun, I hope. I went to school for fashion design, and you know, I never pursued it really. I've always kind of like sewn here and there, altered clothing here and there, but I feel like, you know, my life is passing me by. I'm 35 years old. I'm seeing people that are much younger than me starting clothing lines, and I'm like, if they can do it, I can do it. And yeah, there's a lot of stuff that's overwhelming. Yeah, it's so scary. Like, what if people don't like what I make? Like, what if it's a flop? Like, what if nobody buys it and I'm stuck with all of these clothes that I had to pay up front for? Like, what if I lose thousands of dollars? Like, you know, there's so many things that make it scary, especially when you're like designing this clothing line by yourself and you're like, oh my gosh, like I feel so alone. Like, it's everything is up to me to like make this dream happen. And that's very intimidating, and nobody's gonna be as invested in my dream as I am, you know? And, but that's just like a reality that you have to face, is that like, if you want something, you have to go get it, and like, you can't expect other people to be as invested in your dream as you are. So, all that to say that I am in the process right now of talking to manufacturers and designing a collection, and I'm so excited about it. I actually have a very, very special, like limited release, like one of a kind special collection that I'm going to be releasing, I think in November. I'm working on it right now. I think there's like 30 or 35 pieces of this one item that I'm gonna release. So not a lot. And then I'm gonna release a couple of other things, like kind of like merchy items, if you know what I mean. Spoiler alert, that's going to be coming in probably November. And then I'm working with a manufacturer to like design like a spring collection. Now you guys know. Now you guys know that, you know, there's sad news because I'm not gonna be doing my YouTube anymore, but it's also kind of exciting because I'm going to be pursuing this like dream that I've always had since I was in high school. So I'm excited about that, and I don't want you guys to miss out on anything. Like, I wanna stay connected, and so I'm trying to figure out how we can do that. And I feel like the best way would be if you guys were to sign up for an email list. I'm not planning on sending weekly emails or anything like that, but this would just be for like big news stuff, like my collection releasing, early access to the collection, and like a newsletter sneak peek about like what it's gonna look like and stuff like that. So I want to keep in touch with you. So if you guys are interested in staying in the loop as far as what I'm doing from here on out, I would love it if you guys would sign up for that email list. I'm gonna put the link in the description there down below. And I would also love it if you would follow me over on Instagram. My handle is tiny_acorn. And I'm still gonna be active on there. I'm still gonna be doing stuff, video style stuff. And I'd love to see you over there. I'm also gonna be sharing about the collection and other stuff on there. So this isn't goodbye forever, okay? And you know, who knows? In the future, I might do another YouTube video. I just feel like it's just not what I wanna be doing right now, but I might do it in the future, who knows? But anyways, I am just excited about where things are going from here. So incredibly thankful for all of you. I cannot tell you enough how much I appreciate you. Some of you guys have been like such faithful followers since like day one. You literally were the wind beneath my wings, okay? And you literally helped change this one person's life and help make my dreams come true so that I could be where I am now and have the opportunity to design my own clothes, which is something I've always wanted to do. So thank you so much. Seriously, thank you guys so, 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 so much. I love you. And I think you're amazing. And I know that I will see you guys again in the future. Who knows when that's gonna be? But I'm very excited to keep in touch via the email list and my Instagram. So I will see you guys there. All right, everyone. Mwah. Yes, you're beautiful just the way you are. Bye.